started looking at the incidence of lung cancer in southeastern Kentucky and Appalachia because we received support from Representative Hal Rogers in several years through grants by his office and the federal government. And those were done in the mid-2000s and were primarily screening studies in southeastern Kentucky. As we began to look at the disease in southeastern Kentucky, we found that there's a very high incidence of lung cancer in the region where Appalachia exists. And you can almost draw a line between non-Appalachian counties and Appalachian counties, and there's a huge disparity in lung cancer in that area. And we decided to start looking at the incidence rate and what was causing it and why it was so different in southeastern Kentucky compared to the rest of the state and the nation. And what we find is that although we have a little bit higher incidence of smoking in southeastern Kentucky, tobacco alone is probably not the only reason for that. And we are starting to look at environment, diet, behaviors to try and figure out what the difference is. Is it genetic? Is it because of exposures to trace elements or other toxins in the environment like radon, or is it something else? This study is the first step in trying to decipher why southeastern Kentuckians and Appalachian Kentuckians in general have a much higher incidence of cancer. What we expect to find in the study is a great deal of information that will help multiple investigators at the Markey Cancer Center and potentially nationally to understand our particular problem. We want to bring attention to Appalachian Kentucky about this problem because it's a crisis. And by doing a longitudinal study where we look at everybody that has lung cancer and match them with controls in the region, we should have information to help discern what the tobacco risks are, what the environmental risks are, what types of cancer actually develop because of certain environmental risks, and we're going to, for the very first time, be able to actually catalog what a particular person's exposure rate is for certain trace elements or carcinogens. That's not known in the state of Kentucky right now. We have good general data on some heavy metals or trace elements like arsenic in the groundwater, but we don't have individual patient-level exposure data. And that is critical to try and pick apart why lung cancer happens in this area like it does. So it's personal for me because lung cancer is a terrible disease. I'm an eighth generation Kentuckian. Who better to look at this problem? And we all have a responsibility to do that for our state. And it's such a large cancer burden that I feel really good about the study. I think it will help us. It'll take us many years to understand why lung cancer happens in the fifth district of Kentucky more than it does in Nebraska. But if this is a first step in doing that, then I'm very proud of that. I'm also really hopeful that it will engage the citizens of Kentucky to see that the Markey Cancer Center is doing something for them and to see that they can stand up and be counted in doing something for themselves.